This section should give a short introduction to operational aspects of AIS, functions and features, human aspects. The AIS transponder unit is designed to automatically broadcast the vessel's position, course, and speed over ground, together with static and voyage-related information. After activation, an automatic built-in integrity test, or BIIT, is performed. In case of malfunction, an alarm is given and the unit should stop transmitting. All AIS units are designed to communicate with each other automatically, exchanging information about course and speed and intended route. This enables the mariner to be aware of other ships long before visual contact is established, allowing appropriate action to be taken in good time. The master shall keep AIS in operation at all times, except where international agreements, rules, or standards provide for the protection of navigational information. If the master decides to switch off the AIS, this should be logged in the ship's logbook. The OOW should periodically check that the information transmitted by the AIS is correct. The information transmitted by AIS can be divided into three main groups: static, dynamic, and voyage-related. In addition, safety-related messages could be transmitted when needed. The static information provided by AIS is set on installation and consists of the following own ship data: Maritime Mobile Service Identity, MMSI, call sign and name, IMO number, ship's length and beam, type of ship, and location of positioning fixing antenna. The dynamic information, except navigational status, is automatically updated by AIS. The dynamic data may consist of the following parameters: ship's position with accuracy indication and integrity status, position time stamp in universal time coordinated, UTC, course over ground, speed over ground, ship's heading, navigational status, and rate of turn. The voyage-related data must be manually entered into the system from the operator's panel and may consist of the following parameters: ship's draft, type of cargo, destination and estimated time of arrival, ETA, route plan, and short safety-related messages. The technical status of the AIS is checked automatically by the built-in integrity test, BIIT, but the quality or accuracy of the ship sensor data input to the AIS is not checked by the BIIT before being transmitted to other ships and shore stations. The officer on watch, OOW, should therefore carry out regular routine checks during the voyage to validate the accuracy of the information being transmitted. The frequency of those checks needs to be increased in coastal waters. AIS information can be displayed in various ways, such as minimum display, as alphanumeric information only, or any other suitable device such as radar, ECDIS, ARPA, etc. These symbols are recommended by the International Maritime Organization, IMO, for use with the graphical presentation and display of AIS target data in standalone or integrated navigational systems. The symbols may be changed at a later stage after experience has been gained. A sleeping target symbol indicates the presence and orientation of a vessel equipped with AIS at a given location. No additional information is presented until activated, thus avoiding information overload. This symbol represents automatic or manual activation of a sleeping target for the display of additional graphically presented information, including a vector, speed and course over ground, the heading, and rate of turn, ROT, or direction of turn indication, if available, to display actually initiated course changes. This symbol represents the manual selection of any AIS target for the display of detailed information in a separate data display area. In this area, received target data, as well as the calculated CPA and TCPA values, will be shown. The dangerous target symbol represents an AIS target, activated or not, and indicates which data contravene preset CPA and/or TCPA limits. The lost target symbol represents the last valid position of an AIS target at the time data ceased being received. The AIS symbols shall be similar to that provided by ARPA or radar as far as practical. When AIS information is made available for a graphical display, at least the following information should be displayed. Position, course over ground, speed over ground, heading, rate of turn, or direction of turn, as available. Whenever the graphical display of AIS targets is enabled, the graphical properties of other target vectors should be equivalent to those of the AIS target symbols. Otherwise, the type of vector presentation, radar plotting symbols or AIS symbols, may be selected by the operator. The active display mode should be indicated. The presentation of AIS target symbols, except for sleeping or lost targets, should have priority over other target presentations within the display area, including targets from electronic plotting aid, EPA, automatic tracking aid, ATA, or ARPA. If such a target is marked for data display, the existence of some other source of target data may be indicated, and the related data may be available for display upon operator command. A common reference should be used for the superimposition of AIS symbols with other information on the same display, and for the calculation of target properties, such as TCPA, CPA. If AIS information is graphically displayed on radar, the equipment should be capable of approximately stabilizing the radar image and the AIS information. If AIS information is graphically displayed on radar, the equipment should be capable of appropriately stabilizing the radar image and the AIS information. Target data derived from radar and AIS should be clearly distinguishable as such, and the mode of presentation should be indicated. When the display of AIS symbols is enabled, removing a dangerous target should only be possible temporarily, as long as the operator activates the corresponding control. If the course over ground, COG, and speed over ground, SOG, vector is shown, its reference point should be either the actual or the virtual position of the antenna. If zones, guard rings, or search areas for automatic acquisition are specified and activated, these should be the same for all targets, regardless of their source. Whenever the calculated CPA and TCPA values of an AIS target fall below the set limits, a dangerous target symbol should be displayed and an alarm should be given. The preset CPA or TCPA limits applied to target data derived from different sensors should be identical. If the signal of a dangerous AIS target is not received within a specified time frame, a lost target symbol should appear at the last known position, together with an alarm. The lost target symbol should disappear after the alarm has been acknowledged. An automatic display selection function may be provided to avoid the presentation of two target symbols for the same physical target. If target data from AIS and from radar plotting functions are available, then the activated AIS target symbol should be presented, if the automatic selection criteria are fulfilled. Otherwise, the respective symbol should be displayed separately. The operator should have the option to make reasonable changes to the default parameters of automatic selection criteria. As far as practical, the user interface for operating, displaying, and indicating AIS functions should be equivalent to the other relevant functions of the navigational aid. Current ship bridges, with all their communication, navigation, and other equipment, represent a major challenge to the navigator. The risk of information overload is imminent, which is why many navigators question the value of the minimum keyboard and display type AIS. The solution to this AIS problem seems to be a graphical presentation of the AIS target data.